Throughout their lives, women face a series of blood clotting challenges unique to their gender. Important choices women make about family planning or birth control, pregnancy and childbirth, and the treatment of menopause symptoms later in life all can impact their potential risk for life-threatening blood clots. Why is this important? Each year in the United States, about 900,000 people are affected by blood clots. About 100,000 of these people will die. Annually, more people lose their lives due to blood clots than to breast cancer, AIDS, and automobile accidents combined. Dangerous blood clots often form in the deep veins of a person's arm or leg. This type of blood clot is called a deep vein thrombosis, or DVT. If a DVT is left untreated, it can break off or travel to the lungs. A blood clot that travels to the lungs is called a pulmonary embolism, or PE, and can be life-threatening. Women are more at risk for blood clots during childbearing age, but they also face unique risks later in life when the onset of menopause symptoms occur. The most common method of birth control in the United States is the birth control pill. Most birth control pills contain the hormones estrogen and synthetic progesterone, called progestin, and contribute to an increased risk of blood clots because they cause the level of clotting proteins in a woman's body to increase. In fact, studies have shown that newer birth control pills actually pose a risk 2 times greater than older birth control pills do. The use of birth control patches and rings containing estrogen also increase a woman's risk for blood clots. For the average woman taking birth control pills containing estrogen, the risk of a blood clot is relatively low, about 1 in 300 per year. Patches and rings with estrogen double that risk, and injectable progestin, or DMPA, also may increase the risk up twofold. The risks are much higher for women who have already had a blood clot or who have a family history of blood clots, and they should only use birth control methods that contain estrogen if they are taking anticoagulation therapy or blood thinners. Whether you have a clotting disorder or not, you can plan your family as you choose. There are birth control options that can help you avoid the increased risk of blood clots, including barrier methods, spermicides, the copper IUD, tubal ligation or vasectomy for your partner, progestin-only pills, which do not increase the risk for blood clots, progestin IUD, and the progestin implant. Pregnancy is a major risk factor for the development of dangerous blood clots and can increase a woman's blood clot risk fourfold. This risk only increases up to 20-fold in the weeks immediately following childbirth. The greatest risk occurs in the first week after the baby is born, when it is as high as 100-fold. This tendency for a woman's body to form clots during pregnancy is the result of a natural response to protect women against the bleeding challenges of miscarriage and childbirth. In general, there are several groups of women who need to be on anticoagulants or blood thinning medication during pregnancy, including women who have had a blood clot and are already taking blood thinning medication, women who have had a blood clot in the past but are not currently taking blood thinning medication, women who develop a blood clot during pregnancy, and after delivery, women who have not had a clot but who have had other major risk factors such as obesity. There are blood thinning medications, including standard or unfractionated heparin and low molecular weight heparin, that are safe in pregnancy because they do not cross the placenta or enter the bloodstream of the unborn baby. Use of blood-thinning pills like warfarin or the newer oral anticoagulant therapies are commonly prescribed for many people, but they are not considered safe for unborn babies. After delivery, women with clotting disorders need to resume anticoagulation or blood thinner therapy. Also, women can breastfeed while on low molecular weight heparin injections or warfarin, but the safety of newer oral anticoagulants while breastfeeding has not yet been determined. As women approach menopause, they begin to experience symptoms that are sometimes treated with hormone therapy containing estrogen, which again can increase a woman's risk for life-threatening blood clots. As with birth control methods that contain estrogen or estrogen with progestin, hormone therapy does not cause blood clots. Rather, hormone therapy is a risk factor for blood clots because it contains estrogen. Hormone therapy increases a woman's risk of blood clots up to threefold, and the risk for blood clots due to hormone therapy is much higher among women with a blood clotting disorder or with a history of blood clots, unless they are on an anticoagulant therapy or blood thinners. For women looking to avoid the risk of blood clots connected to hormone therapy, the symptoms of menopause, such as mood changes, hot flashes, sleeplessness, and vaginal dryness, can be managed without estrogen for symptom relief. Women should talk to their doctor or healthcare provider about their blood clot risk factors, particularly if they have a family history of blood clots. Your doctor can help you determine the best family planning options for you. If you plan to get pregnant or learn that you are pregnant, always let your doctor know right away and discuss your blood clotting risks. Women entering menopause should ask their doctor about ways to prevent blood clots if they decide to take hormone therapy or consider alternative ways to manage menopause symptoms. It's crucial for women to understand their blood clot risks and also to recognize and seek medical attention if they experience the signs or symptoms of a blood clot. The symptoms of a blood clot in your leg or arm might include swelling, pain, or tenderness not caused by injury, skin that is warm to the touch, redness or discoloration. The symptoms of a blood clot in your lung might include difficulty breathing, chest pain that worsens with a deep breath, coughing up blood. With the information they need to know about blood clots and an understanding about the spectrum of options that are available to them, women can reduce their clotting risk at these different pivotal life stages. They can stop the clot and enjoy fully the happiness that these life stages offer.